Hello and welcome to this week's OutSystems Advocacy Team video. My name is Jay Santos, and today we'll be talking about how to handle HTTP status codes in REST services. Today we'll be using the REST HTTP codes component available on the Forge. This component was developed by Rui Barbosa from OutSystems, and it's a great way to get started on how to handle HTTP codes on REST services. So thank you very much, Rui. Before we jump into Service Studio, let's have a look at the page that the Forge component offers us to show how we're handling HTTP errors on a REST service. So first of all, we're here in the top right. I have the exception behavior, the way I want my page to behave in case of an exception. So I have default, handle, and silent. Let's have a look first at how default behaves. So if I have a request that returns a 200 code. On the response, I have a successful type of response with all the details populated from the response itself. So no error happened. Let's say I have a 401 error code. So if I click on send request, by default, I'm just using a standard OutSystems error message. Same goes for 403 or 404. And whatever. Now, if I switch to handle, let me just close the window here. If I switch to handle, if the REST service returns a 401 error message, now I am handling the error and formatting it and showing it here in this window instead of having the default error message. Of course, I could do whatever I wanted with this information just to show you that I'm treating it and formatting it. Same thing down here. If I say send an XYZ request, I have the exception called because I couldn't parse XYZ to an integer, right? And same thing here on this exception I had on this request for ABC, I have the exact same message. If I switch XYZ to say 418, I get that this response type is a client error and the status 418. Now, let's jump into Service Studio and see how this is working. So over here, we have the page that we are checking out and the list of requests with each one of the HTTP errors are web blocks that I have added to my page. And over here on the right, I have the response content, which I update with the error information. Now, on the REST service, I have a non-after response callback, which is, of course, called once I have a response from the service. But before we jump into that, let's get back to our web block, our request web block. And depending on the button that you're using, the send request or the handle exception button, we call two different screen actions. So for the send request, we call the go exception screen action, and for handle exception, we have the go trap exception screen action. So if we check the go exception, what I do here is I call the REST service, and then I trigger the response event. Now the response event is set to call the event request response screen action on our page. Basically, what this action do is simply get the response from the REST service, set it to a variable, and refresh the response part of the page, which is this right side here. And that's basically it. And of course, on the go exception, I have a standard general exception handler that shows us the standard error messages that we'd have seen when we were demoing the page. Now, the trap exception, which is called once again when we have the handle exception button, meaning when we are handling the exceptions, is very similar to the go exception, but it also have a customized exception handler called REST. What this exception handler do is to deserialize the JSON wiki response and populate the error message with the exception caught, line break, and the error information. And then, once again, call the response event, which is going to populate the right side of our page. So basically, this is, let's say, this is where the magic is happening, right? But how do we trigger this exception? How do we trigger the REST exception? What we do is now we jump into the logic tab and we go to our after response callback from our REST service. So if I double click on this, so what I have here is my response, the response from the REST service. The first thing I check is if I have an error. So did I return an error? And to do that, I simply check if the status code of my response is above 399. So of course, any HTTP error from 400 onwards are error messages. So if I have an error, I then check if I'm handling these exceptions. If my session variable called behavior is set to deal with exception handling. If it is, then I finally trigger the REST exception. And this is how I would deal HTTP error codes on REST services. On our case here, we also have a silent handling, which I haven't shown, but we can jump here real quick and I can show you. So if I select silent and I get a 401 message, I don't get the standard error message, but I am handling it and setting the information on the response page as well. Because what I'm doing is I am manually setting the status code of my response to 200, meaning I am not triggering an error message. What I'm simply doing is before sending the response, the REST service response to my page, I'm setting the error code to 200, so I am faking a correct return. And once again, when I get back to my request response, I get the response information and populate the right side. But essentially, once again, if I want to handle an HTTP error code with a REST service, I check if I have an error, and all I need to do is trigger the REST exception, which I, once again, handling on the screen action attached to the button. So that's it for today's video. As always, I hope it was useful and interesting. My name is Jay Santos. My email is j.santos@outsystems.com. I'm on Twitter @joutsystems. And as always, any topic suggestions, any action or feedback is more than welcome. Thank you very much, and I'll see you on the next video.